Blackout 650 Gaming here, and welcome back to Game Dev Tycoon. So, last episode, we completely restarted everything, and we made a couple games, and that was pretty much it, so we're gonna continue doing pretty much some of the same stuff now. So, alright, let me double check what all I did last time, just so I remember. Okay, cool, so we're gonna develop a new game, and actually, before we do that, let me research a new topic. Here, let's make a horror game. That should be interesting, right? And then, yeah, I don't know. I don't know what else after that. Yeah. And got it. All right. Now we're gonna develop horror. I don't know. I guess what would be a good alternate name for Resident Evil? Why no? Let's look up synonyms. Let's see here. Resident. Oh, that's not a word. There we go. Okay. Alright. Dweller. That's a good one. Dwell. Is that two L's or one? Yeah, okay, two. Dweller. Alright, and then one for evil. Angry Atrocious? Atrocious, whatever. Bad, baneful, base, beast, what the fuck? Naming games is sometimes difficult. Okay, well, that's true. It's like naming videos is also extremely difficult. A dweller. Maleficent. That's a good little word there. Dweller. Maleficent. Cool. It's the same thing as Resident Evil, but different. It's the same, but different. And we'll put it out on. Now we'll try this. I don't think there's ever a Resident Evil game on the Commodore 64, but you know, whatever. Who cares? I think we're gonna want more gameplay and less engine there. Recent studies suggest that the increasing variety of gaming devices also creates a market for more specialized games. Some platforms become more popular with younger gamers, while others cater for the more mature age groups. As more and more developers enter the market, we expect developers to focus their games on the specific age groups to really make an impact. New research available, target audience. Yay! I haven't been up for very long, so words are difficult. Don't forget creating custom game engines. This will improve your games a lot. You can create your I don't care. I could do that, but nah. Yep. I think hire that in a little bit. Well, see, level design should be up there, I think. I guess more dialogue than AI. I don't know. I really don't make many horror games. I don't play any horror games either, so. Well, unless you count Half-Life. Sound is a really important one for this, as well as world design. But graphics are always important. Okay. Following the massive success of the TES console, there are now rumors circulating that Venna, another Japanese company, is planning to release a home gaming console on their own. Sorry if you can hear a dog barking upstairs. Alright. Just gotta wait. Just gotta wait a little bit longer. Almost done. Alright, I don't care anymore. Yay. Holy shit, everything leveled up. Release the game. Ooh, this is the terrifying part. Shows potential. Have seen better. Falls a bit short. And I like it. Not bad. Not bad at all. So, generate game report. Whoa. Today, Venna has confirmed recent rumors about a new gaming console and announced the Master V. The company claims that the Master V is technically superior to the massively successful DES by Nintendo and plans to release it in the coming months. I'm trying to figure out what it's based off of. Is it supposed to be like the Sega Master System? Who knows? Let's just research that game real quick. Post analysis. Horror action great. Dialogue not at all important. Okay. Kill. Alright, let me see. Have I made profit on that yet? What about the last one? Nope. No profit from that one. But this one, I made 99,100. This one made 133,000. Nice. So hopefully we will make profit on that. It looks like we probably will. Check it now, actually. Yep. Cool. All right. Let's see what contract work is there. We can do that. No, he can do that. And I can tell him to do that. Though technically he is me, so that's not confusing or anything, right? Alright, let's look into this. See what we can do. Off market, sold 9,936 units, generating 69,587 currencies in sales. Actually, says cash, I suppose. So, oh, I had to research custom game engine. Okay, now I can create my own. I don't care. Game tutorials, mono sound. Ooh, mono sound. Oh boy. All right. I have enough for that. Huh, I just didn't click it correctly, apparently. Whatever. Today, new game platform Master V by Venna released. Yay. Oh, I'm really not entirely awake at the moment.
Sorry.
Work faster. Thank you. Game tutorials. Oh yeah, I use those in my engines, right. Well, I'll keep working then. Do it. Fuck. I can't do that yet. Okay. We have to make a game then. Let's develop a game. Business, law, transport. What's a good transport game? Ooh, I know. Ooh. Flight Simulator. Alright, wait. I gotta come up with a clever name for Flight Simulator. Flight. What's another word for flight? Aviation, I suppose. Aviation. I don't think there's many words for simulator. Aviation imposter? That works. called Aviation Impostors. Is it Impostor? Yes. Alright, that's a game. I guess. Should we try it on this? I don't know. PC is the master of all. I didn't actually mean to click that, but okay. Start. Recently released, stirred up market worldwide. Say that the console is not very well marketed in North America, but that will flourish in other parts of the world. Cool. Alright, a little more engine and a little more gameplay. Definitely less quests. Up that all the way, actually. Cool, let's try that. I don't know if, like, my mouse is being disagreeable or if I'm physically incapable of clicking on things correctly, but whatever. That's not what I wanted to do. Oh boy. Okay. That's awesome. Well, oddly enough, I think world design is pretty important for a flying game. And graphics as well. Sound, they're just sort of there, you know? Oh, I can't believe I completely fucked up the second section. Oh boy. Sorry, I had to yawn. Are we done now? Can't get one more design? Just one more? Just one more? Oh god, what? Oh, casual games, awesome. Why? Whatever, just finish it.
Finish it! New record.
And a new topic, and a new combo.
Nice.
Okay, you can go faster now. Release the hounds. Okay. Recent market data shows that the Governor G64 seems to be slowly losing market share against other PC manufacturers. See? In an unofficial statement, a G64 employee said that the company has been unsuccessful in introducing higher-priced computers to compete against newer and more advanced PCs. The first reviews are terrifying and decent. Cool. Cool, 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 cool. Damn.
Can't wait for the sequel.
More, please. Awesome. 7999. Cool. So that should do decently. Awesome. All right, and generate a game report on that. Cool. Let's take a look now. Where is that? Oh, holy shit, 109.5. And it's the highest ranked game I've made so far, too. That's awesome. Post-analysis. Transport simulation, great. Story quest, not very important. Awesome. And PC and simulation is great. Cool. So that went pretty good. Announced they will be introducing a portable gaming device called Gameling. Changeable game cartridges, monochrome screen, wow, on a green background, built-in speakers, and even multiplayer support via connection cable. Damn! Compared to PCs and other gaming consoles, the Gameling is underpowered, Jesus Christ. I swear I can't read. Compared to PCs and other gaming consoles, the Gameling is underpowered, but given the lower cost and excellent portability, it might find a huge following. The Gameling is set to hit shelves next month. Now they announce the system, and then next year it might come out. Yeah. It'd be nice if they announced it next month it came out. That'd be fucking awesome. Aviation Imposter, 242,984 in sales, which gives me a profit of 196,000 cashes. This is nice. I'm already full, you so
neat.
So this is gonna, wow, I don't even know what I just tried to say. Oh, shit, it's been released. Released the hounds. Let's make a game for it. Okay, let me... Actually, you know what? We never... Hold on. Let's, get mono sound now, I guess. Sure. Why not, right? And then once he's done with that, we'll do a, contract work. And then... I'll make the game engine. And then the next episode, we'll use the game engine. Yay. Create custom game engine. Black out. OS V1.0. Can I actually? Oh, cool. That works. Blackout OS V1.0. All right. We'll need that, and we'll need that, and we'll need that, and we'll need that, and we'll need that. Oh, cool. There goes $150,000. Yay. That's great. Oh, boy. I forgot about how long this takes. Also, I'm pretty sure I said that I would do contract work after I research the thing and then make the game engine, but you know, this works too. You can do it. Oh god, what? These magazines offer a great way for new development. Okay, so now I can get marketing. Cool. I rarely ever use that, honestly. I mean, I guess now, this early, it would be good to get some hype so people can actually find out about the stuff. Just when I was, you know, in my gigantic empire, it wasn't really relevant to me.
Yeah.
I will use it in my next game. First, we're going to do contract work. Ooh, this might be tough, but I don't know.
You can do it.
If you have more than 1 million in cash, you'll be able to move to the next level. This might sound like a lot, but don't worry once you... Okay. I haven't. Okay. It's announced the Venegear. A portable console to directly compete against the Gamelink from Nintendo. A spokesperson for the company said, unlike similar devices in the market which don't come close to the AMI consoles, the Venegear has basically the full power of the Master V, except you can take it with you. The Venegear also has a color, a full color screen. Wow. That was difficult. Will this device topple the Gamelink? We will see. The Venegear will debut in 2 months. I don't think it does. If I remember correctly, I think the Game Boy ends up beating the Sega. Was it actually a Sega Gear? I think it was. Whatever. Alright, cool. Well, that's what I said I'd be doing, so, this is a little bit shorter than usual. No problem with that. Makes it easier to export. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Thanks. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and if you did, go ahead and leave a like. If you didn't, then don't leave a like, and I'll see you in the next video.